motor right there.
So check this out, guys. Before this video gets started, I do want to mention that we just dropped some brand new t-shirts on the website with our brand new logo on the front here. You even got some gold flake on the wing. These suckers are super fire and they are super comfortable, and also they're pretty dang limited. So if you want to cop you one and help support your boys, be sure to visit goonzquad.com. But as of right now, let's get to the video.
Ready for the full throttle launch, though?
Dude,
pedal to the metal.
Say less, man.
All right, here we go.
Let her rip.
What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So today we are here at the original goonzquad garage, where today we are finally back on the Tesla builds. As you guys seen in the past couple videos, we brought in the brand new classic car build where we got a bunch of parts already in, and that's just gonna be a super epic one on its own. And of course we brought in the jet boat as well, but that build is pretty much over with. You might just see it added in some of the other videos here in the future, because that boat is pretty sick as well, dude. Can't wait to do some more ripping in that thing, dude.
For sure, dude. And we got a few more things that we wanna add to it to make it even more epic, dude.
Definitely, man. With this heat right here, man, you just gotta be out there every once in a while. But anyways, what we got here for the Teslas is basically all the parts to get this sucker 100% complete. But instead of actually focusing on this Tesla, what we're gonna probably do is focus on the 2016 model here, because we got the front subframe for this sucker and also the rear subframe for this, just in case we wanna get this sucker rolling around, just in case we wanna just move it to a different location.
Or just move it, you know, test drive it.
That's exactly what we're gonna try to do. We're gonna try to get the subframe on it, and maybe we'll have to steal some parts from this one just to get it driving around, because we got like the control arms right here. This is like some of the stuff we need to get this thing on all fours. But then we didn't order like a shock right here, which I think we can straighten that sucker out. And then there's a drive shaft in there that's bent, I believe, or broken. So we might just, that's the only thing that we're probably gonna steal from this one.
Yeah, it's just a drive shaft. Yeah.
But dude, that's what we wanna do. We wanna see what this thing is all about, because I think we did mention that this sucker has more horsepower than this one. So we can't just immobilize this one and not test it out. You know what I mean?
You never know. We may even go ahead and buy a quarter panel and a door and just get this thing 100%.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, it would be nice to have two Teslas. You know what I mean?
Hey, what's better than one, too, man? Tesla, like we said.
Well, I think if we do get this sucker driving today, which we're actually gonna have to probably charge this sucker up, because I think both of the batteries died.
I think they're completely dead after sitting out.
I don't know if they're all drained. They probably just somehow like cut off. What do you think?
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe they completely drained from doing all sorts of stuff. So we'll just plug it in, charge them up, and then we'll be ready to test it out.
But as right now, I think first thing we should do is probably open all this stuff up just to make sure that it is the correct parts, because you never know, things do happen. But I believe we got the right parts here. Then I think we're gonna go ahead, lift this sucker up, probably start removing that damaged, subframe
and suspension,
all that stuff right there, and hopefully get the new one in and possibly get this sucker ripping. Crazy this stuff looks,
dude, it looks,
man.
Looks like it straight out of some kind of race car or something, dude. Or all aluminum, dude.
Dude, or out of like something that belongs in outer space.
Yep, that could be a possibility. But dude, look at this, dude. We finally got the parts that we were waiting for like over a week now. And dude, we can basically start throwing these Teslas together, dude.
We can basically finish up the 2020 edition, because we got the front subframe for it right there, which was super difficult to find, which huge shout out to Dennis from Silicon Valley, dude.
Yeah, for sure, because without him, dude, we wouldn't have been able to actually locate these parts, because I believe he drove a couple hours to get this front subframe, which is just awesome, because dude, this is going to make us throw that 2020 together in no time, dude.
Yeah, when Dennis came out here and started the Audi A7 for us, he basically just became family after that, because he just like hung out with our parents here, also hung out at other family there. Dude, I'm telling you, he's coming back out here, man.
Dude, especially once we finish up these Teslas, I believe he wants to come out here and like reprogram some of this, the computers and stuff like that, and get these things back on the road, dude.
Exactly. But it's so crazy, dude, how you meet new people just just like, literally, he reached out on email, and I was like, all right, just call me up. And then I was like, yeah, just fly on out if you want to.
Hey, and that's it.
We don't usually do that, though.
Yeah, you know, we don't usually do that, but when you're able to, like, to figure some stuff out that we can't figure out, like computers and stuff we're not big into, but, dude, he's helping us out with all that stuff. So, and look at that, dude. He got us some front frame rails.
Oh, I about said subframe, but we do got the front and rear subframe right here, but more importantly, dude, we got the front frame rails, both of them, dude.
Both of them. So we decided to go ahead and get two since there was two available, and, dude, these came off of 2020, so they're going to go straight up in there. All the brackets, all the mounting points, they're exactly the same. And, dude, these are just perfect, man. We could have saved that other one over there. It had a slight little kink in it. We could have probably, like, straightened it out. But you know what? Might as well get two, dude.
Yeah, I think that'll be the best way to go, just to ensure that the structural rigidity is there. Although most people would probably be able to save that no problem. But it's just going to make it so much easier, I think, to swap both of them
way
together.
Way easier. We're just going to put them in there, bolt them in there, do a little bit of Panabond, and then do, like, one or two welds on each of them. We may have to call Vasily Builds back out here. And, dude, that front end is basically going to get slapped in. Dude,
it's going to make it a breeze after that. But as of right now, the next biggest challenge is probably going to be working with this rear subframe, because we got to remove that one. And I think you got to remove that rear motor as well, dude.
I think it all drops at once, which this is going to be awesome, because as you can see, these motor mounts right here. So this thing is just going to get bolted down, but it almost looks like it's on one, two, just four bolts, and this thing should slide down. Of course, we're probably going to have to take some suspension out and stuff like that. Maybe unplug the motor and stuff like that. It's going to be epic, dude. But we'll probably have to take those quick jacks, throw them on here, lift that up. And I think we got it, dude.
Alrighty, guys, so quick little update as we move right along. We try to get that rear subframe out. First things first, we ended up actually going to pick up some more jack stands, right?
Yeah, more jack stands. That way we can take the quick jacks away from this thing. We just have this thing sitting on all fours right now because we just want it sitting like that while we're working on this car. It's a lot easier to work on and stuff like that. But we got this sucker up with the quick jacks over here. And, dude, we're already taking stuff apart back here. I mean, we're just mainly unplugging stuff because there is quite a bit of electrical components going on. And we unplugged the main power source to the rear motor. And it's these two plugs right there. One positive, one negative. And, dude, that's some crazy stuff right there.
Dude, you're touching them like nothing's going to even happen, dude. Do you think there's juice?
I don't think there's juice on these metal parts, but on the inside, definitely. But I'm just not going to touch any of them. I'm just going to leave it like that. But I don't believe there's power going to the batteries right away. I think it's mainly
when you step on that alligator or accelerator,
the accelerator or something like that. But who knows? We're gonna be precautious with that. The batteries are super low, so I think we're good.
If it's a zap, it's gonna be a minor zap, nothing crazy. But as for the jack stands, we are using the 6-ton jack stands all the way around, so I think that's pretty safe. I don't know how safe it is, but I think it's safe enough, dude.
That thing probably weighs about 10 tons right there.
No, the thing is not that. I think it weighs 6,500 pounds right there, right? A little bit over it. So that's perfect. 6 tons, dude, that's plenty. Over here, we got the jack stands, and then we just got the support beams all the way around, just in case.
Yeah, definitely. Just in case those suckers fell, we got some wooden blocks up under there. But, dude, we're almost ready to pull this thing out.
We're gonna
start taking apart some of these brake calipers and stuff like that. That way we can hang them instead of, like, undoing the brake lines. Maybe take apart the shocks that that way this stuff can all drop, like probably take this off, hang these things up over here. And then once that's done, we're just gonna unplug like the ABS and a few other electrical components. And then there's just four bolts literally that are holding the subframe
with the motor on top of it. The only thing that's kind of slowing us down is probably the heat a little bit.
100%. It's super hot today and it's humid because it just rained last night, so everything is evaporating, getting super hot. But that fan over there, man, that cool fan is just cooling us down, and I mean
that's keeping us going, dude.
Keeping us going. But honestly, I wish I was in the boat right now.
Hey man, we might have to take that thing out. But no, I really want to see how this thing is gonna rip around.
Yeah,
it. So that's
we don't
our
even
main
know
goal.
If it drives, because it came to us not running drive, you know what
that's
I mean?
That's true. So I say we keep on moving and plug a few more little things and hopefully end up getting that whole entire motor and subframe and all out of here, dude.
Let's do it. Motor right there, dude.
Oh my goodness, that's basically the whole entire rear powertrain of that Tesla,
dude,
right there,
everything,
dude.
Motor, suspension, all the wires and some coolant lines, that's everything you need. And it was actually surprisingly way easier than I thought, dude.
Definitely, yeah, it was pretty simple. We actually unplugged a few things that we didn't have to, like this right here, because there's basically like a main wiring harness right here, dude.
Yeah, dude, so three plugs there, a couple hoses, four bolts, and there you go, the whole rear end, dude.
Dude, this is epic. That's the motor, and I'm guessing the transmission built in. I don't even know how that even works right
yeah,
there,
I'm
dude.
Guessing this is the like the small transmission, probably like sitting right here. I guess this is the electric motor or this. I don't know what side it's on, but dude, that's crazy how small it is compared to a gas engine, dude.
This is the future right here, and this is what allows you to have a frunk in the front and then a trunk space in the back,
yeah,
basically, dude.
Because usually when you have a rear engine car or a mid engine car, you have no rear space to put stuff. But this, since dude, it's so small, you got space everywhere.
Exactly,
dude.
And I'm guessing what this is like roughly 200 horsepower with the front makes it 400 horsepower
yeah,
total.
I don't know how that works, but somewhere we have 400 horsepower,
exactly,
dude.
But dude, this is the damage of this subframe right here. It's kind of light damage. I wish we had these pieces, would have just sparked those suckers clean up, and also this right here. But you know what, that rear subframe wasn't too expensive, was
yeah,
it dude?
It was like $500. It's better to go ahead and get a new one, since we are gonna probably get this thing for real fixed.
Yeah, we're gonna
you know?
Get this thing running for real, dude.
Yeah, so might as well just go ahead and throw in a new one, you know, don't have to worry about nothing like that. We do have to order one of these little sway bar links. We don't have one, but you know what,
we don't need that for now.
We can throw that in and just replace it later on, because we're going to just be doing some minor test drives.
Yeah, we're
going to
be hitting some dirt roads, some back roads, and we need that flex anyways,
dude. I just want to see this thing go into drive and drive under its own power, dude.
That would be super epic. Another damaged piece is going to be this Brembo e-brake right here, which look at this Brembo motor, dude. Look
dude,
at that,
that's
dude.
A little electronic motor right here that actually actuates the electronic or emergency brakes right here, and it does unbolt. So if we can find a new one of these, we'll just throw it in there instead of replace
it. Hey, dude, that's going to be a challenge right there trying to find it. That's going to be like trying to find Waldo, dude.
Yeah, what do you say? A Tesla Brembo? Or you can probably just look up electronic Brembo brakes, and they're probably all the same.
That might be an easy part to find, but that's pretty much it right here. Also, our axle shaft just got completely obliterated. Got some guap, some goop right there.
I mean, it's still good, dude. The bearings in here are still fine and stuff like that. We can probably just pop that sucker back in and be able to drive with it. You
be
know
good
what I mean?
To go. It might wobble a little bit, but we're not going to go to any high speeds, are
no,
we, dude?
No, sir, dude. No, sir. Just maybe no, sir.
Maybe no, sir. But anyways, let's hop up underneath this car and look how it just hollowed everything out, dude.
This is crazy right here. So this is everything completely gone. Here's the main power.
Lick 'em.
Positive and negative just going straight to the motor. It's pretty sketchy unbolting these things,
dude. It is, dude. How do we test if it got power? Like, you were trying to lick him, but the way to really find out is if your hair stands up.
If your hair stands up, you got plenty of power. But honestly, the batteries are completely drained, and if you really wanted to test it out, you have to, like, shove something in there, and we're not going to be doing
no,
none of that, dude.
No, sir, dude. But look at that, dude. There's your coolant. It kind of runs, like, through the tub right here. Here's your shock. This kind of bent. I think we're just going to straighten this sucker out for now and then probably be on the lookout for a new one, dude.
Later on, we'll do a new one. But, dude, this is where all the main power lines come out of the battery. It's crazy. They run to the front. There's some that run to the back. And, dude, that's just it, man. That's pretty simple, man.
That was super cool, dude, just taking this out and just exposing all this stuff and just finding out how this car is just made. That's just awesome right there,
sir,
dude.
But now it's time to start doing some swaps.
Yeah, we're basically going to go ahead, probably drop this sucker on the ground. And look how simple this motor is going to be able to remove.
Two bolts, dude, and a few wires and stuff like that. And that's it, man. We'll probably place them both side by side. That way we can pick up the motor with a skid steer, start swapping everything over. Then we're going to throw it inside the car, throw the wheels on, and have this thing sitting on all fours. Alrighty guys, so check this out. Quick little update here. First thing I want to say is this thing about got us beat, especially with the heat and all. I'm even wearing Crocs with no socks, and that's a very first. I'm always wearing socks in these things. But you know what? We are moving right along. We are determined, and look at what we accomplished here. We got this whole entire rear subframe completely assembled. We got the motor right here. We got the suspension. We got the wiring harness. We got everything pretty much, dude.
Dude, this thing is basically ready to go. I mean, we even threw in that other axle shaft right there, and that sucker is spinning, and we're hopefully going to do some grinning.
And we're almost grinning. But actually, one thing that we didn't notice earlier is this sucker actually has three motor mounts, and one of them was broken, so we didn't end up throwing it on. We just got two of them on right here. But you know what? I think it'll still run, dude. It'll just have some crazy torque, dude.
Hey, man, it'll just do a little bit of hopping. Maybe you won't even notice it. You never know, dude. It's a pretty nice little small motor mount that's aluminum. But we did order one off of eBay for like 80 bucks or something.
Yeah, so we'll throw that on. I think you could throw it on after the subframe is installed, which this sucker is almost ready to go. We are running into one more issue. We did mention that the shock is actually like bent or broken, and we were going to try to straighten it. And look at this, dude. We just completely broke that sucker
clean off, dude.
And what we're going to do is probably just go ahead and weld this sucker up as straight as possible because this is just temporary. You know, we want to get this sucker driving by tonight, dude.
Yeah, dude. We are just determined to have this thing moving under its own power, dude.
That would be epic. The sun is moving quick, but you know what? We got this welder right here. We're going to fire this sucker up. We're going to weld this sucker clean on here and then hopefully get that subframe right there installed. Alrighty guys, so it is actually the next day here, and dude, check this out. It's finally sitting on all four wheels and tires. We threw that subframe engine and wiring harness and everything back in this thing last night, hooked it all up, which was pretty dang easy, just figuring all that out. And dude, I believe this thing will drive now, dude.
And it's looking good right now because the bag's kind of deflated, so we might just leave it like that.
Yeah,
dude.
I think we kind of like released some of the air pressure out of the rear bag, so the rear is just sitting down. Hopefully like air's back up once we put this thing in drive or something like that. But dude, man, I'm just super excited. And we charged this thing last night because this thing was at 0%, dude.
Yes, sir. And we charged it at a low wattage, what, like 10 amps or watts? I don't remember what it was.
Yeah, like 10 something. That way we don't overheat the batteries because of what? We have like low coolant in this thing.
Low coolant. Plus we're missing the radiator, the AC condenser, which I believe all that like works together to cool the batteries and the motors and all that good stuff.
Yep.
And we went ahead and got like, what, 20%
dude,
now 20%, or something?
20%. Like charged for like 8 hours and 20% is all we got. But I think that's perfect enough to at least throw this thing in reverse drive, just test it out. Yep. Dude,
I don't think we're gonna do too much ripping today until we get that radiator on, but if we can at least get this thing moving, that's just gonna be huge, right?
Dude,
there, dude,
once we get this thing moving, we're definitely gonna have to order some radiators and AC condensers for this car because we're gonna get this thing 100% ripping.
All right, what's it saying in there, dude?
I mean, it's saying like a bunch of doors
oh
and stuff
goodness.
Are open, but we're gonna go ahead and just I guess put it in reverse, right?
Yeah, pop it in reverse. Oh, the e-brake is locked up, but it's still good though. It just had to break free, basically. Is your parking brake thingy off there?
Yeah, it's off. I think it was just stuck because it's like so much rust on it. But, dude, here it goes.
Let me hop back here. I got to see the whole thing in one shot. Go for it, dude. This is wild, dude.
Dude, this is crazy,
that thing is rusty, though. You could tell it's been sitting for like a year, probably.
But, dude, it is... Dude, this car is driving. This is crazy, man.
Okay. She made it in reverse here, dude.
Are you
dude.
Guys ready for the full throttle launch, though?
Dude,
pedal
say,
to the metal.
Say less, man.
All right, here we go.
Let her rip. What the heck is that? Dude, is it running off of one motor?
Dude, I don't know, but that was pedal to the metal. I mean, we do have like a whole Christmas parade going on our dash
right here.
Plus some, and it popped up a little turtle emblem, said engine power reduced. So we're in turtle mode,
dude,
right
we're
now,
in turtle
dude.
Mode. We got to get it in rabbit mode, but I think it makes sense because like all those lights are on. It's probably reading that there's no radiator, no coolant. And on top of that, it looks like some door panels are open or something like that.
Yeah, dude, it's reading a bunch of weird stuff. The AC is like picking up higher and higher slowly. The screen doesn't like work. It's just stuck on this one screen right here. So we're just going to have to figure this thing out, dude.
I think what it needs is a full charge, maybe some more coolant, a reset if possible. And then once we unlock that full potential, dude, then we're going to do some crazy ripping.
It's over with. But guys, that is pretty much going to be a wrap for today's video. Didn't get to do much testing on this thing, but you know what? We knocked out the major goal, which was actually to get this sucker driving. That way we can move it around on the property. That way we can focus on the 2020 Tesla. But also we might turn this thing into something pretty epic as soon as we unlock unlock all the power that this thing has, but you guys are gonna have to stay tuned for that. Make sure your post notifications are on so you don't miss out on anything. And also, if you want an inside scoop before YouTube, definitely give us a follow on Instagram at goonzquad. Also guys, don't forget, we just got some brand new t-shirts on the website with a brand new logo. You got a little bit of that gold flake. These suckers are super fire and they are pretty dang limited. So if you wanna copy one and help support your boys, be sure to visit goonzquad.com. But with all that being said, thank you guys so much for all the love and support. Be sure to drop your comments and thoughts down below. We'll catch you guys next time. Peace.